Is it evil?
No, but it's not good either. It's neutral. Will you slay it?
Hey, I think I've spotted something nobody else has seen before. Adventure Time is inspired by D&D. I know, an absolutely wild discovery that fundamentally changes the way we look at the show. Okay, so it's not a new discovery per se. Everyone knows that Adventure Time has some similarities to D&D, but I don't see that many people actually talking about this. Yes, there are fun references to game systems and lore within the show, but more than that, Adventure Time feels like Dungeons & Dragons. Right to its very core, the rabbit hole goes very far down. No, not like that! Let's start with the direct references that show the writers and artists working on the show are familiar and love the source material enough to homage it a lot. There's the obvious, like characters directly discussing alignment.
If a good guy really liked her, could he change her to good?
Well, there'd be penalties to her experience if she acted out of alignment. But yes, someone could change her.
Yes, very subtle. And there are a lot of iconic monsters, the Mimic and Gelatinous Cube from the episode of Dungeon being two of the most obvious for my money. There's also plenty of magic items that would be exactly the same if you introduced them in a D&D setting. Classes that make you smart, as in literally give you a bonus to your intelligence. Finn and Jake are seen using multiple weapons throughout the series, as they are continuously upgrading them with weapons they find from their various dungeon expeditions. There's also many examples of cursed items that all D&D players will be greatly familiar with. The show's logo is remarkably similar in font, colour and design choice to the 3rd edition Dungeons & Dragons logo. Even the swords have many of the same design elements. All this shows a clear love for the game, but it's all surface dressing compared to the feel and tone of the show itself. Adventure Time does not just have D&D references, it is D&D. Watching the show is closer to watching Critical Role than any other animated program. In an interview with the show's creator, Pendleton Ward, he said this.
I just played a lot of Dungeons & Dragons when I was little, and watched a lot of crazy cartoons.
If that's not enough evidence for you, he did another extensive interview with Wizards of the Coast, the publisher of D&D, but also the publisher of Magic the Gathering. Oh my god, would you look at that? Also, Adventure Time's intro is remarkably similar to an animated trailer for one of Magic the Gathering's expansions. Stop copying Wizards' homework, Pendleton. In the Wizards interview, Pendleton talks about how the writing process is done like a game of D&D. The creators are too busy, so they play with the characters they're writing. Our stories primarily come from either a funny story someone tells in the writer's room, or from Pat McHale and me wanting to play Dungeons & Dragons, but we can't because we're at work, so we end up writing a story that feels like we're playing D&D. Ward gives the example from the episode Rainy Day Daydream, where Finn and Jake are going through their treasure room and suddenly invisible trolls show up. This is a great example of the show's writing feeling like a session of D&D. The players, Finn and Jake, are arguing over loot, so the DM has them attacked by some random enemy they made up on the spot to keep the session moving and to stop the players getting bored. Every episode has this playfulness in the writing, like the writers are a group playing a session for their writing process. Every episode, a little one-shot adventure that they take their characters on. A great example of this is the episode where Finn and Jake are fighting in some old ruins, an extremely D&D setting. They then enter a coliseum, where the King of Gladiators offers them a chance to fight, and at first Finn and Jake leave, thinking it's dumb, but return at the chance to fight ghosts. This entire interaction I could see happening in any session of D&D. So much of very early Adventure Time has the feel of what's called a funhouse dungeon. A funhouse dungeon is a style of game where you are exploring fantastical locations with bendy rules. A far lighter tone. The exact same sort of locations Finn and Jake explore tons of in the early series, like in the episodes Dungeon, The Enchiridion, and The Limit. Most early D&D adventures did not give story hooks to players. It was just assumed they would want to explore dungeons and kill monsters because that was the game. Finn and Jake kind of encapsulate this mentality perfectly. Hell, the subtitle of the Adventure Time video game is Let's Go Explore the Dungeon because I don't know. Kind of the perfect attitude for our intrepid heroes. This playful energy is everywhere in Adventure Time, with its candy people, its cloud kingdoms, and its dungeons that seem to litter the land of Ooo. Something happens in later parts of the show, however. The group stops wanting to just explore one-off dungeons forever, and start wanting to do something a little more dangerous. More high-level content. The episode Mortal Folly introduces the Lich. Well, technically he has a tiny appearance in the earlier episode His Hero, showing that Billy was originally the one who imprisoned him, but this is the first time Finn and Jake meet him. The Lich is a genuinely scary, menacing threat to the world of Ooo. He has no gimmicks, Even his colour palette is made of darker shades of black and green, making him contrast to the vibrant world and its characters. The Lich's design also shares a startling similarity to the artwork of the Lich in the very first D&D Monster Manual. Coincidence? I think not. The Lich offers a fresh tone to the show. The episode itself is not overly dark, but the Lich is always presented as threatening and not played for laughs. The Lich is not funny. This antagonist is not a bumbling fool like Ice King, the only other antagonist the show has really had up till this point. In fact, Ice King's role in the episode makes him a great contrast. The Lich really helps with the longevity of Adventure Time. I feel people would have gotten full on the show, the same way you can eat too much candy, but the Lich gives an amazing bit of bitterness to help keep things fresh. On the other hand, pun very much intended, the Lich also saw a change in the show. Yes, the next episode is a light-hearted romp, but from this point going on, the show had a lot more dark elements thrown in. This for the most part was great, it meant creators had the opportunity to add more complexity to characters, exploring more sides of them. Ice King went from a one-note foil to this kind of lonely old man who feels Finn and Jake are his best friends. This is all great, it adds more life into the show. And I think it's part of the reason Adventure Time had such a large fanbase. The darker scenes only get more prevalent, and they're some of my favourite moments in the show. I mean, this scene is just so damn perfect.
Before there was time, before there was anything, there was nothing. And before there was nothing, there were monsters.
Pendleton said in the interview with Wizards, he hoped to explore more Lovecraftian elements in the show, and they certainly did. There are a bunch of surreal, downright creepy episodes. And like I said, they're some of my favourites. Also, just as a little side note, D&D has always had a very close relationship with Lovecraftian imagery. I'm just saying, just putting it out there. Later Adventure Time has a lot more of these surreal, creepy episodes. And there are less and less one-off adventures of Finn and Jake going, exploring funhouse dungeons, or questing in Ooo. The original appearance of the Lich was so shocking because it mixed things up so well. It clashed with the show so much, both tonally and literally. But when this becomes more and more the norm, it just starts to become the norm. And I didn't start watching Adventure Time to see a cosmic horror story play out. Eldritch abominations from beyond the stars and a dog that goes into a pocket and then farts don't really mix tremendously well. If early Adventure Time is a group of teens hanging out after school and exploring dungeons their DM is making up as he goes along, but nobody notices because everyone's having such a great time, then later Adventure Time is the same DM going through a bit of a phase. He wants to make his story deeper, more interesting, but he's too attached to his current setting and characters to start totally fresh. Or you can read it that the same DM is handing the reins over to somebody else, who is adding deeper characterization and stuff into the story, and everyone else loves it, but doesn't quite know how to handle the extra complexity, so they go back to pocket fart jokes. When the storytelling keeps adding these complicated elements, and you have to work them back into the previous funhouse dungeon exploring, and you somehow have to make those two different clashing things fit together, you get some weird situations. Okay, so you see Finn is actually a comet that landed on Earth, and there's another evil comet that is the Penguin, but that doesn't come up till much later, and Finn gets reincarnated every like generation or so, and he used to be this person who was friends with Princess Bubblegum, but he's also used to be a butterfly before that. In addition, there's wizards and they have madness and sadness, and Jake is an alien, and
stop.
When a DM gets so caught up in their own lore, they kind of miss the point of the game. You get into situations like this. So overblown and overindulgent to a show that previously had scenes like this.
Hey, don't squeeze me, I'll fart.
The tone discrepancy is practically heavy, you can feel it weighing down on you. At the end of the day, Adventure Time was always a show that was written as the writers went along. And yeah, maybe the writers got a little bit precious with their ideas, but so do DMs sometimes. There's nothing wrong with starting a campaign one way and having it change as it goes along. Hell, these games often last so long that you'll probably be very different people by the time you fight the final boss. Watching Adventure Time is the experience of sitting down with friends, going room to room, killing monsters, finding loot. You see this group change playstyle and tone, but it's always the same group of friends getting together and just having a great time. Thanks for watching.